to the city hall.
Thank you very much, Sheriff.
Morning.
Okay.
Hi.
How are you?
Mr. Mayor, nice to meet you. Hey. Very honored.
Thank you. Thank you for visiting the
office. What a welcome, man.
You see the band.
Hi.
Nice to meet you.
Good morning. Ah, sorry, my deputy.
Morning. Please.
I wasn't expecting such a welcome.
No, it's okay. Please.
Because sometimes in other countries it's a little bit improvised, but this is
I think they make practice.
How are you doing? Very well. Thank you for hosting me this morning. I already, since a long time ago, I wanted to meet you. You have a good story in this country. It shows that the country can actually select the best and the most interesting people to have an important part. And also, especially now, my intention was to commemorate the 30th anniversary of the Convention on the Rights of the Child. I think we're one of the six that initiated the convention in 1991. And so it's the 30th anniversary of the convention that celebrates and casts in stone the rights of the child. I know you have a special childhood in a sense.
That's why, Your Excellency, if you noticed that about 2 weeks ago, we implemented a stricter law on two things. One, really care for the kids and being neglected by the parents as per our mandate with regard to national law and our law. So we really try to care for them and put them in facilities for safekeeping initiative and hopefully to send it back to their respective parents. This is never going to be a regular cycle. So what we did 2 weeks ago, we continued to care for those kids in the streets. Then we penalized their parents. Because I told them, who would care better than the government? It's the parents. You know, my mother, I literally did let fall from the crash. But my mother would not allow me to stroll around in the middle of the night. We have this word, the street, Sansui. When our parents would say, psst, or we go home, especially at 6 o'clock. Everybody is inside the house. While they're poor, while what they call informal settlements, they give it informal settlements community. My mother would always care for them. So I don't know what happened to some parents in our case. I don't know if they lose hope. They have so much challenges in their life. But still, you know, this is unacceptable. No matter what kind of challenges you have, you just don't throw your kids in the streets, especially in the middle of the night. So what happened next, I thought that some groups of individuals will go, might go against the stricter rule with regard to parents and more care for the kids. We gain a lot of traction in support because it's now a perennial situation. Good thing, for this year's item, Your Excellency. It's been 2 weeks. You will never see 17-year-old below in the streets of Manila. unless they are accompanied by their parents. So it's more peaceful nowadays. Lions are virtually eliminated among minors. And we keep on getting those kids by Tala or Tapaki and not even part of the city by they see something. And I always tell them, why am I did not do those things? Well, I'm exposed to those things. Especially my friends, my colleagues, what I think that is. Then I will expect it. It's a matter of choice.
We are one of the reasons I'm here to see you because I think you are aware that we invite you on your birthday, the 4th of October. Not for your birthday, but you will have a cake.
I like your chocolates. Godiva.
Yeah, you will get some chocolate.
I went to the old store when I was in Netherlands. Because I was asked by the president to be part of the ongoing peace talk with NDF and government. It's like Gapo from Netherlands. All I have to do is to ride a train. In 2 hours' time, I'll be in Belgium. So we visited that park. No, it's not a park, it's a plaza.
Yeah. Grand Plaza.
The Grand Plaza. The library is like nearby.
And there's a couple of there.
So I saw those cobblestone being maintained by the state. But time the people to let them know where they belong, who they are. So I always tell we have to protect our children. Those countries are moving heaven and earth, bending everything just to protect because that's what you call the sense of belonging. So it reminds the youth. Out of this country for quite some time. I think I've traveled half the world, the very least. And I've seen a lot of simple changes that affects the daily habits.
So I visited, Belgium is funding a few NGOs. Not as you have read in the press to finance the communists, that this is a long story. But we have a few projects in the field of street children. In particular, in Bacolod, there is a project with Virlani Foundation. And they are putting up a center for street children during the day. So it's compatible with your policy. They don't keep children during the night. There is another NGO working with the wife of the child, Kio. So we want to bring these people, and even street children, at the table on the 4th of August with you, and we can discuss your policy, the responsibility of the parks. I think I fully agree with that. Not substitute to what the local government.
Sure, we'd we'll be happy to receive help. Any help you do, particularly with kids and things.
I think the French foundation, Virlani Foundation, has some ideas and projects to work with you as a mayor. So it's not only chocolate.
But you're the best.
There's nothing like a free lunch.
them happy because they see their owner content made that we'd be happy with you.
So your mandate is what, 3 years?
3 years.
3 years. Mm-hmm. Renewable.
Depends if you would
elect you. I'm sure they would elect
you. The maximum 9 years. That's why I started in government, it's at the age of 23. As I literally finished at the 9 years as council or 9 years as vice president. I was appointed to the cabinet, which is very impressive. So, half of my life was dedicated to public service, so very important for me. So, I started at 23, so that's about 21 years.
You look younger than that.
Yeah, now I like it. I'm 19.
Yeah.
19 December.
Something else, I can show you a picture. We were Saturday morning on the beach in Manila, cleaning the beach.
Seco.
Yes.
16,000 people.
Amazing.
Acceded to our.
That's the ambassador cleaning the beach. Wow.
Galen. Nice. Thank you.
But the thing is, I'm a little bit scared because I thought just cleaning the beach, you just pick up the plastic and that's it. But the plastic is so fragmented that it's impossible to clean the beach. You have to invent a machine or something because just pick up millions and millions of different pieces of plastic. Is really bad. But and also, so cleaning up the beach is not possible. Cleaning up the ocean is not possible. It's too late. What can we do as a mayor and as an ambassador of culture to prevent people from just trashing the plastic in the sea? We have a few ideas. There's some companies interested to recycle. In Paseco, for example, we had a village next to the beach. I didn't see any garbage selecting plastic. And we have to start doing that in Belgium. I think we are the most, the country that recycle the most. But selective gathering of trash is very, very important. So what? It's going to continue. We're going to clean Paseco Beach for another 50 years.
I hope.
Have to stop the
source.
Yeah.
In fact, we're going to introduce you pagkain sa basura. Pagkain sa basura, because I used to be a garbage collector. What we're going to do is, from the household,
yeah,
we're going to buy their garbage.
Food for waste.
Food for waste.
Yeah.
Food for waste.
But it's going to be in a coupon way. Coupon type.
Mm-hmm.
So that no money, no monetary involved. I'm involved. Just quantify every type of materials you have through segregation. You get it, quantify it, put the points on every recyclable materials. And those points can be converted into X kilo of rice, sugar, the basic commodity, coffee, milk. We're going to do that next year because I'm now operating under the old budget, the past administration, and we saw that there is no direction to the current budget. We have to prepare. In fact, yesterday I just approved the 2020 budget with regard to cleaning the city, creating more open space, open green space. So the entire infrastructure project, 80% of those input, making the city greener. And another office which will handle this, I'll talk to them within the week on how to fund those programs with regard to food for garbage food.
Just a question, what, once you have the plastic, what you, will you find a company to recycle it? Or?
Yes, we can have it.
Sell it.
The city to block building, anybody can join and buy recyclable materials for recycling purposes. I should know it very well, I have PhD in garbage. I've been a garbage collector for 10 years of my life and a poor boy for 18 years.
PhD in garbage collection.
That's why when I discuss it with the public, a lot of people, I told them, you know, in Europe, they have this an ATM machine for garbage. You just put your bottle in a machine, and it's going to give you money. Or if it is located in a restaurant or in a grocery store, put the bottle there, plastic bottle, glass bottle, wine bottle, it doesn't matter, all bottle. You put it there, then they're going to give you a coupon. Then you go inside the store.
And you buy.
Then you can buy anything like that. So it's like a rebate concept with regard to groceries.
Maybe the big Rostan and SM would be interested in such a
thing. Yeah, this machine was invented by the Americans. I saw this machine already, but
it's right in Belgium and France.
Yeah, in Europe, I saw it also. But we'll do it the way we know it, the way I like the idea, but the concept of having it in an ATM machine, maybe tomorrow my ATM machine will be gone. Maybe.
One other thing I learned Saturday morning is it's not only plastic that you find on the beaches. You find medications. You find batteries. You find lighters. You find everything life can produce. And so it's really, and especially batteries, it stays forever and it's polluting the ocean. So it's not only, the problem is not only plastic in a sense. And in Europe you have in every shop a place where you can buy batteries or recycle. Batteries are terrible. Anyway, maybe I'm putting in contact, you in contact with,
yes, please.
With that French company. It's called Plastic Flamingo. You know a flamingo, it's a big bird.
It's a big bird.
In plastic. I don't know why they named their company like that, but it's a fun. And they're very dynamic young people. And what they want to do is recycling plastic into construction material. So put your bottles in everywhere, and then you get a piece of material to build your house, and you solidify your house.
Sure.
Plenty of ideas. Mr. Mayor, thank you very much for your welcome.
I've never had a welcome
like that in my life.
You're always welcome. We have something for you.
President Stern.
Yeah. I really love something for you here in our historic wall.
Oh, look at that thing.
Thank you, Excellency.
like it.
That's why a lot of people here.
Smartphone. You go to the camera. And because I was a computer,
wow.
This is something about the
very, very, very. So let's work on our lunch.
Yes.
I promise to bring you a cup of tea. Thank you very much.
Oh, some assistant.
Okay. Atid ko lang ha.
Yes, sir.
Lang
ha.
Come on.